Where'd you go to school?
A secret stopover.
How long have you served for?
His first trip to the Middle East as Prime Minister, not publicised ahead of time for safety reasons.
Thank you for your service. Thank you for your sacrifice, not just of yourselves, but of your families.
Al Minhad base, crucial to the Afghanistan evacuation, saving thousands of lives during the fall of Kabul almost a year ago.
The efforts that were made during that hectic period in August were quite extraordinary.
Just the beginning of a major international tour, starting with the NATO summit in Madrid, not just focused on Russia, but China's aggression too.
NATO is also important to Australia for what it can do, contributing to Australia's interests in the Indo-Pacific.
France, a key player in keeping the peace and stability in the region. A meeting in Paris with President Emmanuel Macron viewed as an opportunity to reinforce new relationships after the dumped submarine deal. Fresh missile strikes casting new security concerns over a possible visit to Kyiv with Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky.
But while the Prime Minister is expected to be welcomed by world leaders on this diplomatic dash, his government can't escape the fury of crossbenchers here. They're demanding Anthony Albanese halt his plan to cut their staff numbers, threatening to block government bills in response.
I won't have the resources immediately at hand to review any significant proposed legislative reform. The natural response is to vote against any progress in that area.
It's not me being dudded, it's the people of the ACT, which is really disappointing after an election where so many Australians decided that they actually wanted independent representation.
One minister suggesting the matter is still open for discussion.
I've certainly had some discussions with independent senators about it. They've given me their feedback and, you know, we'll continue to talk.
The Prime Minister so far standing firm on the cuts.
Sacrifices have been made across the board.
A political dream run for the new leader, now facing turbulence ahead.
And Shubha Krishnan joins me now. Shubha, the Prime Minister hasn't been able to shake off these domestic issues, but they aren't the only challenges he is dealing with en route to Madrid, is it?
That's right. Anthony Albanese has had a phone call to the Solomon Islands Prime Minister Sogavare for the first time since becoming leader. This is significant because we know the Solomon Islands have recently signed a controversial security pact with China. It's unclear whether this was discussed, but the pair will meet in person next month for the Pacific Islands Forum in Fiji. Now, it's since emerged that China is actually pushing for a meeting with the region's foreign ministers on the same day as leaders come together in Suva. It's been reported by the ABC that 10 Pacific Island countries have been invited to this virtual event. Now, Ricardo, this is a clear sign that China is trying to muscle in its own agenda during this crucial time.
Okay, Shubha Krishna there. Thank you.